Welcome to the Pion press channel. Today I decided to make a short work video. This is probably my most common real work task, and it's repairing a damaged bearing surface on electric motor bearing housing. So there is, I'm not sure, I can zoom in, I take this. So here you can see the bearing surface is corroded during use, and it is now too loose for a new bearing. So we must repair that, and the method to repair damaged bearing surface is to machine this hole a couple millimeters larger, so I can put a metal ring into it and then machine the installed ring to exactly right diameter for new bearing. So first task when repairing this is to get this part in my lathe. When machining this hole bigger with my lathe for the new ring, I must be able to mount this piece right this way in here, but there isn't any surface ready to mount this bearing housing to my lathe, so I must first to mount it from here and then machine surface to this side to get it placed other way to the machine. So first we are going to machine that surface, and there is already, I think these three are supposed to use when you are machining this side, so I must get the paint out from there and make nice mounting surface to do the rest of the work. So now we have our part mounted to lathe, and we are starting to make the mounting surface to finish the job. And the part is quite large for this lathe, so I want to first be sure that it's able to spin whole circle before switching the machine on, to be sure there is no collisions or anything like that. Yeah, it seems like, well, then I engage the right gear, and when machining anything that isn't mounted optimally, you must lower your machining values to meet the demanding situation, so I'm not going very fast. It's this one, and there is no need because there isn't a lot of machining to do with this task, so the machining time won't matter that much. Yep. Yeah, so now it's just touching the part, and I zero that again and find out. And I am going to take 1 millimeter away from this piece diameter. So that isn't much, but it doesn't need to be much, and it is not very securely mounted there, so I want to be careful. And it is also always demanding when the machining isn't continuous, but this pounding type. I think I'm going to make 15 millimeters long mounting surface. That is more than enough. Maybe 13 is enough. Yeah. I'm gonna check. Yeah, no, we now have that much of mounting surface. I think I take a bit more of it. Maybe one more millimeter. Now we have these mounting surfaces where we can mount the piece to be able to machine other side. And now the part is mounted to lathe on the right side out, so I just changed the tool for whole type of tool. I think this one is suitable for this part of. This is too far back and the front side of this part is going to hit the part if I don't use this to fall. But this is quite in bad shape, this one. Yeah, now we try again. That the part is able to spin. Yeah, everything's fine. And then I choose the right speed. I think I'm again going quite slowly because this is not optimal mounting. I think this is probably the enough speed. Yeah. And first I must zero this from the back of the bearing housing to be able to know when I must stop the feed. Now I have zeroed also the diameter of my tool and I think I'm going to machine 2 1 millimeter. Six slices of bearing housing to make room for the machine. So now this part is ready to it's in that state that we can install steel ring to that machined surface to make the hole bit smaller and be able to machine that after it to right size for new bearing. But I must take this off and we are going to make that steel ring to be glued in that hole. So here I have material for bearing housing replacement ring and we are going to mount it to the lathe. And then I am going to take excess material of the hole away so I don't need to machine the hole so much when it's glued to the bearing housing. And then we are going to machine top side of or outside of ring to match the hole in the bearing housing. So I think I machine the hole part and then the outer side. So I must take right tool. But now the part is little better mounted than the bearing ring, but it isn't still optimal. So I won't go at full speed to make sure that the part stays in the lathe. now the inner diameter of the ring is 1 millimeter smaller than the new bearing, so I left it there and we machine that to exact size when it's screwed to the bearing housing. And now I'm going to machine the outer side of this ring to exactly the same diameter as the bearing housing is right now, and then I'm going to glue it. Now I have taken one chipboard, what you call that in English, a tray from the top side, and I have resetted my digital display to that. And I am going to measure this and then measure how much this is bigger than that and take that much off. And when I glue that to there, the glue allows to this be about 0.1 millimeter smaller, or if it's little bigger than larger than this one, I can still use hammer and make it fit. So this isn't have to be exact, this doesn't need to be very precise, so I use my mitutoijo measurement, just this model, not the micrometer. This is enough for this one, but this is really good measurement. I don't use any other brands than Mitutoijo. And these are waterproof, so the coolant doesn't break these. Now I have that zeroed to this diameter, and then I just compare it to there, and now it's 17.15 millimeters over that. So I wind my lathe to zero and put that reading to the digital. Yes. And for now on I have to use the coolant to keep that part at room temperature, or otherwise when it cools down it would be too big large for the housing, so I must get this one close. And now we have 3 millimeters left to machine, so I change to smaller feet to get more accurate result, and take one more chip off and measure, and then take the final. just take it like this. And then I grind this sarpetke to smoother to help with the installation. And then I change to different tool. With this tool I can cut this one to match the hole dips in the bearing housing. I just measure it with my. So the hole depth in the bearing housing is 36 millimeters and the width of this tool is 4 millimeters, so that is 40, and then I leave some extra to help with the hammering. The part inside the housing. So I zero that there and then four and six more. Can I use some tool to cut the string and now you have my metal ring to be glued to the bearing housing. With these ones you have to be extra careful because this edge right here, this is extremely sharp and it can cut your gloves. It can cut your gloves too and your fingers also, so you must do that. So now I have both parts cleaned with brake cleaner and I'm ready to apply the glue. I have this Loctite 638 which is meant for stuff like that, and it's high strength glue, so it should use when you are not planning to remove parts after that. This one, so I just put some glue here and maybe a bit there. Yep. And then I just carefully place that about straight and sound changes when the part is all the way in, so I can hear when it's ready. Now it's metallic sound when the bottom is hitting to the bearing housing, and then I just wipe the excess glue off. Yeah, and now the replacement ring is installed and the only thing left to is machine this surface to match the new bearing. So now I have my bearing housing again in my lathe and I have a finishing tool ready. And now we are going to start the last phase of this prepare. I want to one more again check this. Really can spin there. Yeah, it can. Then I touch the bottom of this hole to make. Yeah, now everything is ready. I start the machine like that. And then I am going to touch the part with the tool to get the zero point for my cubicles. First I'm going to take a really small amount of material away to just to get my digital set in, and then I'm going to make two finishing machine chips. Okay. Measure the hole and put this. There's still 0.5 millimeters to left of machining left, so I divide that by 2, so I take 1.75 millimeter chip and then I measure it again and then take the last one. The last two chips have to be exactly the same in every way to get very accurate results. Because if I take 1 millimeter off and then take the 0.5 millimeter off, the result would change. So now I take the 0.75 millimeters away. Usually with this finishing tool, the chips don't break very easily when you end up with just one very long, which gets tangled up to everything. But now it's going to be, now it's going very well. I'll take my air contact to remove any dust particles. And then I take my measurement. Yeah, it's about 0.7 millimeters left, but we need more accurate measurement. So I go and get better measurement tool. So I have to make last very accurate measurement to figure out how much material I still need to machine off. So for that I have these powers 3. micrometers. They are very accurate and I have them from something quite small, like 6 millimeter to up to 200 millimeters. They are quite expensive, but they are really easy to use and very accurate. So I just put it there. Yeah. There is 0.67 millimeters to zero, but this is non-drive side bearing housing, so we want to make it a bit loose, like 0 to 0.02 millimeters. Yeah, I think I'll go with the 0.67. Now everything is set and the final result should be quite cool. Now the hole is ready and I just need to cut the excess length of the string away. Then I round the edge of the hole with the hand tool. And now the part is ready and my phone is ringing, so I must answer that. So now the bearing surface repair ring operation is ready and I can once more check that our bearing surface is right size. Yeah, it is about 0.075 millimeters over zero, so it's just perfect for non-drive side bearing housing for electric motor. Yeah, now the job is ready and I just call customer that their bearing housing is ready. Yeah, I think that is all for today. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.